I'm pretty sure the entire internet is over a tirade over what Chris Rock said about Will Smith's wife in the Oscars. Well, I actually been thinking and digging deep about what I consider to be one of the worst video game franchises to have ever disgraced its presence in not just video games, but gaming as a whole. Yes, I'm talking about a franchise that is so bad, so fucking broken, it'll make you question as to why you even liked the franchise as a kid to begin with, or even question what was the thought reasoning behind this game being created in the first place. So what I did was I actually looked back at a trilogy of video games, and I've actually decided to talk about it and share my thoughts on it for the internet to behold. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring to you the worst franchise in the history of video games, and that is the Gex the Gecko franchise. Before I begin, no, I'm not talking about the Geico Gecko ads where the Geico Gecko inserts himself into different video games like Tetris, Cuphead, Oregon Trail, and so on. I'm actually talking about Gex the Gecko. Three letters, one syllable, rhymes with sex, though it's anything but sex. Gex the fucking Gecko. One of the worst, most embarrassing franchises in the history of the medium. I also want to, before I begin, ask the fans this. What are you really doing with your life trying to wait for a new Gex game? Why don't you all go do something more productive with your time, like go play better quality games like Banjo-Kazooie, Rayman? Hell, why even go play Super Mario 64? That game has more ROM hacks that I can count on all of everybody's hands and fingers on this planet than I would any ROM hack of Gex ever created. Really makes you fucking think, doesn't it? So, without further ado, let's actually talk about the Gex the Gecko franchise. For those who don't know what this character is, he is voiced by washed-up comedian hack named Dana Gould. Dana Gould in this day and age is a wash-up because he does nothing but complain about Trump supporters on Twitter all day, and he even makes all these virtue signaling jokes, which, yes, we get it. Trump is bad. He's out of office now. Get over it. But I'm getting way ahead of myself here. I'm gonna talk about the first game. The first Gex came out on a console that nobody fucking owned, and that is called the goddamn 3DO Interactive Multiplayer. It cost $700, which was $50 more than a better video game console called, I don't know, the Neo Geo. It lasted from 1990 to 2004. This son of a bitch actually did a 3-hour-long documentary talking about what makes it so great versus the fucking failure that is the abortion called the Panasonic 3DO. The only noteworthy games to come out on that platform was, again, Gex the Gecko. And when people actually play the games, they actually look to him as the mascot. Similar to how Mario was the mascot of Nintendo and eventually Crash Bandicoot would become the mascot of the PlayStation. Also, I don't know what journalist was bought and paid for when they thought that Gex would be the next mascot on the Sony PlayStation when clearly Spyro and Crash were the better choice. So the first Gex came out in 1994 for the 3DO. One thing that separates it from the rest of the competition is how the 3DO version not only runs at a worse frame rate, but it also has a save feature. Kind of reminds me of when fucking Coleco released Donkey Kong Jr. on inferior hardware just to grandstand their new ColecoVision version of the game way back in the day, but who knows? The controls of the game are slippery. As evidence, Gex is a fucking lizard. He slips and slides all over the goddamn place like he's at the fucking ice capades. He doesn't even stop, he doesn't have any good traction, but he can climb on walls like a real gecko can. Though, what practical use is that? There's no real background walls to actually climb upon. They're so few and far fucking between that it'll really make you question, why was this feature even implemented? It might as well be an average Joe Super Mario clone. With how slippery Gex is, it'll even make Luigi question his own manhood, if he even has a manhood to begin with. So, after the first Gex sold poorly due to the console, Crystal Dynamics, yes, that very same Crystal Dynamics, the same people responsible for the Tomb Raider games, as well as the infamous Avengers video game, which is not the worst game to ever come out of them, unlike this, what I'm talking about right now. I'm going to be talking about the character's big dynamic shift into big scary 3D, Gex Enter the Gecko, released on the PlayStation, Nintendo 64, and Microsoft Windows. Yeah, that's another thing too. Before the game actually came out, Gex was ported to almost every console ever made except the TurboGrafx, because TurboGrafx was done by then. Neo Geo, because seriously, who owned a $650 Neo Geo? I await the day when someone says, I grew up with a Neo Geo. Seriously, if you actually had one as a kid, congratulations, your parents did really well. Regardless, let's get back to this. Gex found himself ported to the PlayStation in 1995 as a launch title. It certainly didn't sell as many units as Rayman, because Rayman ended up becoming the best-selling game in the PlayStation in Europe, outselling both Tomb Raider 2 and Gran Turismo. So why the fuck would you ever consider wanting to buy a game for a shitty video game console that got ported to so many other platforms? Then a year later, after more units didn't sell, Crystal Dynamics released Gex onto the Sega Saturn. Yeah, that was also not a very successful video game system. TurboGrafx 16 outsold it, 10.5 million units, versus the Sega Saturn's 9.5 million units in its lifetime. Again, really makes you think, doesn't it? Then again, Gex was never a successful franchise to begin with. Go figure. Regardless, Gex's final release in 2D would end up coming in the form of the Microsoft Windows PC iteration in 1997. That was when Crystal Dynamics ended up working on Gex Enter the Gecko. After milking the series Call of Duty style, they actually decided to take the character into the leap of big, scary 3D. Let's see how it went. Well, it has directional controls, but that is the only compliment I'm going to give this game. Because when compared to other 3D platformers like, again, Super Mario 64 and Banjo-Kazooie, the camera will eat your fucking soul. There is no worse camera of a video game that you will find on any other video game franchise than Enter the Gecko. It is the worst, most unresponsive camera you will ever find in a video game. Who was controlling this? Lakitu's drunk brother or something? Gex Enter the Gecko is the character's leap into big scary 3D, obviously borrowing or rather stealing from Super Mario 64 in terms of gameplay progression. Or in this case, regression, I might want to bring up. So you're given a choice between 2 and 3 missions, and you basically just hop and bop about, you go tail whipping all the different things. Dana Gould reprises his role, talking non-stop about like outdated pop culture celebrity number 46,853, and it's tail time that. Seriously, you could pretty much have a drinking game of every time Gex says it's tail time, but I would advise against it, because let's just say you will actually die of alcohol poisoning. I would not recommend this even to my worst enemy. Hell, I wouldn't even recommend it to fucking JStation, and how he would actually not be out of place with how he would actually be in a Banjo-Kazooie game, with how many times he says, guys, over and over and over and over and over again. Gex Enter the Gecko fucking failed. Why did it fail? Banjo-Kazooie came out that same year. Banjo-Kazooie set the golden standard for how free-roaming 3D exploration in platformers should be. If you grew up playing Gex Enter the Gecko and not quality games like Rayman 2, Banjo-Kazooie, or even hell, why not play Donkey Kong 64 way back when 3D platformers were the shit and not first-person shooters as they would in the 2000s and beyond? I'll say this. You're a loser. You're an absolute fucking loser. So, as one final Hail Mary, Crystal Dynamics decided to release in 1999 Gex 3 Deep Cover Gecko. So how did they get this game to sell, and how did it become an alleged 6 million plus seller and get himself into the public eye? Well, they actually hired a Playboy model named Marlise Andrada, nowadays going under Marlise Krebs. Yes, she did in fact get married. But I'm getting ahead of myself here. The game is pretty much the same as it was in Enter the Gecko. Originally, it was going to be a 2D Metroidvania on the Sony PlayStation and Nintendo 64 with 2D graphics and gameplay, as evidenced by how 3D didn't really fucking work for the franchise. But yet, somehow, the mad lads over Crystal Dynamics managed to focus more on the graphics than the actual gameplay itself. So Gex 3 Deep Cover Gecko borrows the same formula, the same worn-out Super Mario 64 mission-based formula with actual collectability from Banjo-Kazooie. Hell, the game is pretty much a plagiarized carbon copy of Banjo-Kazooie. Characters with googly eyes? Check. At least Gex doesn't talk in different sound bites. So I guess that's a plus. The levels are more varied and the graphics are more impressive, and like I said earlier, it seemed that the developers over at Crystal Dynamics managed to make the graphics more important than the actual fucking gameplay. You know, the very foundational pillar that makes video games like this an essential timeless classic. It's not pop culture references, it's not about how you can make so many fucking jokes about Rush Limbaugh before it really gets old, and how it really showcases your personality on Twitter. I'm actually talking about how the game itself is just plain not fun. Why do I even play this as a kid? Because honestly, I had nothing else better to play with my time. I could have played Glover, but even then Glover got himself a Steam release that fixes the draw distance issues. Another thing I want to talk about the Gex games that are in 3D is the draw distance. The draw distance is so fucking horrible it put fucking Silent Hill to shame. Banjo-Kazooie got it right with fixed camera angles. This game, not so much. And that's my entire synopsis on the entire Gex the Gecko trilogy of platformers. Now, I could talk about the shittier versions of the Game Boy games, or even rather, this one canceled iteration that was going to be on the Panasonic Jungle. Yeah, a successor to the 3DO, a handheld version of the 3DO called the Panasonic Jungle. Neither do I know nor do I care. Don't even buy any of the Gex the Gecko games. Hell, don't even download the ROMs to them. You could obviously play better 3D platformers that are worth your time and space and the time-space continuum of the Ultraverse and the Megaverse. Playing all these Gex games makes me want to go have a buffalo take a diarrhea dump in my ear, and also makes me want to eat the rotten asshole of a roadkill skunk and down it with Rolling Rock Angry Video Game Nerd style. So with all that said and done, I hope I changed your mind about the entire Gex the Gecko franchise. These are my two cents on the entire franchise. Really begin to question your life about what it is, what makes these games great for you. I think that's about my entire tirade. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Until next time, I'm out.